Alright, here we are for round one. We are on the draw, and yeah, I think we have a pretty fine hand. We are missing white mana, but we have plenty of spells we can cast anyway, and our early spells are not white. Alright, so we're probably playing against either a mirror or a Jeskai. We'll see which. Alright, that was about the worst draw we could have. Okay. Well, I guess we'll jam another Swift Spear and just hit for two. I want to leave up Wild Slash in case our opponent plays like a Rabble Master next turn. Draconic Roar. Okay, so we're playing against Mardu then. I'm going to guess anyway. I guess it could just be red-white. Oh man, we're so smart. Kill your Rabble Master. Okay, that was a good draw. Stoke, I don't think that's what we're interested in right now. We have Chain for his first dragon. Stoke is good if our opponent plays a Storm Breath. So it is Mardu indeed. Ash Cloud Phoenix. Alright, well, we'll hit with our Swift Spear and play a Seeker. We might actually just be able to race Storm Breath anyway. Ash Cloud also does a ton of good work against Storm Breath. And we also can't neglect that our opponent did not reveal a dragon to Draconic Roar, so that makes it somewhat less likely that they actually have a dragon in their hand as well. Does he just have nothing? Could have like Mardu Charm, I guess. Yeah, I'll go ahead and play Abbot pre-combat. If we hit a Swift Spear or a Wild Slash, we'll want to cast it right away anyway. And this lets us somewhat play around, lets us play a little bit around Crackling Doom because we can sack the summoning sick creature. Although, I think if our opponent had Crackling Doom, he would have just cast it before. Well, maybe not. What is this? Oh, just a very full retail murderous cut. Sure. Okay, a Soulfire Grandmaster for us to kill. Just gonna go ahead and strike it. Think I'd still rather be saving Chained for a potential Thunderbreak Regent or whatever the Colgan. Yeah, Colgan. Probably gonna get Crackling Doomed here. Sure. Alright. Pretty good, actually. It's a pretty good draw. Doomed again? Sure. Crackling Doom is not very effective against the Horde of Goblin tokens, fortunately. There's the Storm Breath. Which we'll go ahead and kill right now. And then hit for two. Slowly but surely working our way through this pile of dragons. Okay. So our opponent's going to probably be at like 7. Takes the Ashclad Phoenix. That makes a lot of sense. And then I guess if he has another Storm Breath, that would be annoying. Yeah. That is annoying. Is he going to attack? It seems ambitious. Oh, I guess it's... Yeah, we die if he monstrouses now. So if he draws a land, we're dead. We can cast two of the cards in our hand, but we're going to be stuck with one, unfortunately. I guess he's winning. Yeah, he wins the race just barely. Cold again. Yeah, that kills us. All right, well. That was unfortunate. But what can you do? So, sideboarding. Don't like Chain of the Rocks very much against this deck. I do like the long game cards. I do like the Valorous Stances are okay. I think Lightning Strike is pretty bad. Wild Slash kills all the same things. Don't think we want Soulfire, but I think we do want all three of the Valorous Stances. They kill the Thunder Breaks and the... they don't kill Storm Breath, obviously. We have to have Stoke for that. But they kill the other things, so I think that's good enough. And they save... The stances can potentially save our guys from sweepers, which I think are problematic. So let's give this a whirl. Alright, here we are for game two. We're on the play. This hand is great. Just need to hit that Phoenix on time, and I think we should be in really good shape. Alright, another Phoenix should be really good, assuming that we hit our fourth land. Nyx Fleece Ram. Well, I guess that's a Valorous Stance target. I think that's better than... Yeah, I think I prefer that over Hordling Outbursting this turn. Lets us keep up Wild Slash if he has Rabble Master, and lets us just get in. Got another? No, got a Grandmaster. Okay. I'm going to kill that one now, then. And our opponent is also missing a land drop. So, that's good news for us, to be sure. And this opens us up a little bit to anger if our opponent draws the land, but we have to just get them dead. And also, we still have a lot of gas left. So if he does have anger, like, it's probably better to get it out before the Ashcloud Phoenixes start coming down. Okay, another Soulfire Grandmaster. Well, I'll play the... Well, now I really don't want to play Outburst, because if he has... if he does have anger, it's like really annoying. He gains so much life if we've played the other Outburst. And yeah, I think it's better to play around that. So we'll just hit for two and pass. Fingers crossed for no angers. If he attacks, I'm just snapping off the triple block for sure. Anger it is. Land, please. Well, not the land we wanted. Perhaps the land we deserved. Do not need another one, though. Gained so much life. Put him right back in this game. Alright, well, I have to... Well, that's probably better to play than Phoenix. See what he does about these goblins. They gonna kill off some of them? So we revealed a Thunderbreak. Alright, with this little pressure on board, I think I am gonna go ahead and play a Phoenix. You can attack through a Thunderbreak if he plays one next turn. We do lose out on a turn of Outpost Siege being in play, which kind of sucks. But if our opponent doesn't draw a land anyway, we're just going to crush him. So now I'm definitely going to play the Siege. Probably going to have to kill off our Phoenix here if he has a way to do so. And then we'll just go ahead and play Siege. On cons. Alright, I smell a Thunderbreak Regent in our future. Yep. It's in there. Let's see what we get. Couple of lands. Alright, well, I'll just play another... play the Swift Spear. Play this Phoenix face up. And I think we just pass. It's really bad if our opponent has Anger, but we still have, like, Outpost Siege going, so it's pretty... it's not unlikely that we would just be able to find a removal spell for the Thunderbreak and move on with our lives. And then, like, you know, it's basically a top deck war again where we have... oh, he's Downfall? Okay, well, that's fine. He's attacking? This is so aggressive. So I think we just play Sarkhan here and kill his guy. Basically trade Sarkhan for the Thunderbreak and get in for 8. I think that's better than plussing. If we plus, we get in for 12, but he could play, like, Colgan or something and mess us up. This way he still basically has to Anger or he's in a lot of trouble for next turn. He chose to deal the damage to us. Very aggressive. So you could have Crackling Doom, I suppose. That makes the most sense, I think. Alright. So after seeing a little bit more of what's going on, I think... knowing that he has Rabble Master and Soulfire still in his deck, I think we want these Lightning Strikes. And we can maybe board out, like, Chandra on the draw is a little slow. And if we draw, like, a Chandra and an Outpost Siege, we'll be really sad. And maybe we board out, like, a Swift Spear. to help us play around Wrath a little better. Alright, I think I like the looks of this. Let's give it a whirl. Alright, here we are for game 3. We're on the draw. Our hand is very good, I think. We have protection against Rabble Master, Storm Breath, and yeah, I think we have all of our bases covered and we have a little bit of card advantage to boot. We'll go ahead and scry to the top, actually, I think. I think we want to hit our land drops this game. So if our opponent doesn't do anything, I'm probably still not going to play Abbott on turn 2. Yeah, I'm still not going to play Abbott on turn 2 here. I want to play around a potential Rabble Master, and I want to have a higher chance of casting whatever spell we hit off Abbott. I actually think we want to Lightning Strike this rather than Wild Slash it, because of the fact that we're going to play Abbott next turn and probably hold up Wild Slash. So this way we can still offer Rabble Master if one should come a callin'. Thunder Break. Alright, well, we have answers to that. No reason to stoke it now. I think it's very unlikely that our opponent has Valorous Stance in their deck. Now, however, I will go ahead and deal with it. So we just did nothing. Yeah, I'll play Storm Breath. Pretty likely that this is going to get doomed or something, but we have three, like, functionally three dragons, so hopefully we can just run him out if he has ways to kill them. Yeah. That's fine. Doomed away. And I want to play Sarkhan last. That way, if he play, like, the ideal play pattern with Sarkhan is that he plays his dragon, and then we go, like, we untap, play Sarkhan, and eat his dragon, and then he has to use a removal spell on Sarkhan still. So that's what we're hoping for there, like, if he plays a Storm Breath this turn or something. Okay, as a way to rebuy his Thunder Break now. Ooh, that's a good draw. Still gonna just play Storm Breath this turn, I think. Well, maybe it's better to play Ashcloud now. Yeah, it's probably better to play Ashcloud. I guess I can attack with Abbott. No, I should play the Ashcloud first, because I'd rather sacrifice it to, if he has Crackling Doom, I'd rather sacrifice it, and if he blocks with the Nyxley Swarm, I'm going to Wild Slash it. And then I can sack the Phoenix to Crackling Doom instead of having to sack the Abbott and getting 2-for-1'd. So presumably Thunderbreak is headed back to his hand. and we're getting doomed, maybe? Looks like we're probably also getting doomed, which is definitely okay. Yeah, it was a doom indeed. So there's a Thunderbreak, and he's pretty much out of cards at this point. So we can play Sarkhan and eat Thunderbreak, or we could just try. I think I'd rather play the Sarkhan and eat the Thunderbreak this turn. We probably end up getting our Sarkhan killed here. Yeah. But we get the Thunderbreak, and then we go ahead and attack. See if he wants to block. He does. Alright, now there's no point in Wild Slashing before damage. We can just let damage happen and then Wild Slash it. That way we don't get blown out by like his own Wild Slash or whatever on our guy. And now I'd say we're sitting relatively pretty. Yeah, Storm Breath happens. It's probably going to be too slow to race us though. So we just cast our own Storm Breath. Hit for 8. And then next turn we have Monstrous available. So we're dead to, like, Colgan exactly. Otherwise, I think we're in pretty solid shape. And I feel like he would have cast Colgan before if he had it. And we win. I don't think we were actually a lock to win the game. I think we were just very likely to. Like, next turn, if we just attack with everything, he could block the Abbot. We Monstrous the Storm Breath. He takes 1, assuming that whatever card he has in hand is just uncastable. And then he could still kill us if he top decks like Colgan or something. So we probably would have just attacked with Storm Breath only then. I don't know. But anyway, we'll be back for the finals. We'll be right back.